Okay, we're here speaking with Alison Forman, former Australian international player, now working with the Dana Cup as marketing manager and one of the key personnel involved in that tournament. She's visiting here in Trinidad and Tobago, obviously, for reasons with the Under 20 Women's Championship playing and interest in Trinidad and Tobago. Tell us a bit more about this.
Well, we've been in Philadelphia in the USA at the National Soccer Coaches Convention. We're always present at this convention to promote our tournament and our academy. We have a girls academy and a top professional women's club back in Denmark. And at the same time, we got introduced to yourself over here and found out that the Under 20 CONCACAF was being played at the same time. So we thought it was a fantastic opportunity for us to come and check the situation here with the players and with the teams that were here, and also discuss the opportunity to get Trinidad and Tobago, some youth teams, to come to our tournament. The Dana Cup, it's been around since 1982, so it's an old tournament, but it's a very famous tournament. We're the biggest sporting event in Denmark, and we're the third largest youth soccer tournament in the world. So we gather 1,100 teams from 45 nations each summer in July in Denmark. And our tournament is it's not an elite tournament, but it caters for both. So we get teams of all kind of different qualities that come to our tournament from all around the world.
In terms of the running of a tournament of this magnitude, you mentioned earlier in terms of, you know, it's really about passionate people who are involved.
Yeah.
How do you manage to run sort of such a tournament every year, so many teams? Go through that for us a bit.
Well, basically we have a 25-person group that are the leaders of all the different sections of the tournament, like the transport, the referees, the accommodation. They're all volunteers. They've been working with us since the start of the actual tournament. So there's a lot of routine and there's a lot of things that they just do like clockwork, which is absolutely fantastic. Apart from that, we have around 1,500 volunteers that work on the ground within the different sectors of the tournament. And if we did not have the 1,500 volunteers at our tournament, we would never be able to run such a tournament. So it's all based on the volunteers and people, you know, getting out and being passionate about football and helping within the organisation. Tournament. Last year we had Liverpool under 16 girls team that came in, won the tournament. We have most of the top teams within Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Germany as well, because they're very close to Denmark, so it's easy for them to come down. We attract also top clubs in Germany, Mexico, Brazil, all around the world basically. So it's a very popular tournament and it's a fantastic tournament.
And what do you hope to build in terms of a relationship with Trinidad and Tobago going forward?
We hope to welcome some teams this year, hopefully. I know it's a short notice, but we would like to welcome them to our tournament and create also, we were looking at some players that play on the national team. Like I said, we have an academy and we have a women's team which plays in the UEFA Champions League. So we hope to create a relationship where you can send players, you can send teams to our tournament, and at the same time we can send maybe our academy team over here, our first team, to play some games, because we're always interested in expanding the dimension of what our players experience at all levels. I think it's fantastic. Like, I think the quality of the women's game is just getting higher, from the 17s, 19s, 20 up to the senior level. So I think the tournament has been fantastic, good organisation, and we look forward to seeing a couple of more games.
Alison, it's a pleasure having you here with us, and we want to wish you the best.
Thank you very much.